Here is my video on details of a scrapped hard drive. This is not a video on how to take apart a hard drive. If you want to see that, watch my first video. Taking off the retaining ring, it is held in with 4 or 5 aluminum screws. It is made out of machined aluminum, and if you have a bag of them, they actually sell quite well on eBay. They can be used in arts and crafts. Here is the Readwrite Actuator. It moves back and forth, reading and writing information onto these very shiny platters. Now, these platters are made of either aluminum, ceramic, or glass. They are coated with cobalt and then with a very thin layer, like 1 micron thick, of palladium or platinum. These discs have to be absolutely perfect or they don't work. The manufacturers put the palladium on the disc by a manufacturing process called sputtering. I'm basically saying it is an oxidized layer of palladium. Do not waste your time trying to recover the palladium. You would need thousands of discs just to get 1 gram. Now, here is my favorite part of every single hard drive I take apart, the neodymium magnets. This is the most valuable part for me in scrapping hard drives. If you put 10 of these together, you can get anywhere from $15 to $75 on eBay. The neodymium magnets are mounted on a bracket made of MU metal. When scrapping hard drives for profit, leave the magnet attached to the bracket. Here is the Readwrite Actuator. The actuator is made up mainly of aluminum. It has a copper coil at the end and a ball bearing assembly in the middle. I took this macro shot just to show you the size and scale of the read-write tip of the actuator. This shows you actually how much gold is in there. It's not a lot, but as you can see, it's quite bright and quite pretty when you can get a close-up view of it. Now, attached to the side of the actuator is a ribbon, and in that ribbon there may be gold tracing or copper trace wiring leading up to the data connections. Now, the metal actually inside the ribbon is copper. You will find gold plate leaf underneath the ribbon around the data head. The gold leaf is extremely thin, and separating it from the ribbon is extremely tedious. The only way I could see to efficiently separate the metals from all the plastic in the ribbons and the data heads would be to incinerate them and then separate the metals chemically. Here is the second half to our pair of magnets. What makes the neodymium magnets so great is how strong they are. They're very powerful for their size and they're extremely fun to play with. If you can get hard drives from the early 90s, the magnets are much larger. On newer drives, you're going to find smaller magnets, but just as powerful. Now, the next part is what most scrappers go after. Some people just unscrew the circuit board and toss the rest of the drive into the aluminum pile. The hard drive circuit board is where you're going to find most of your precious metals, starting with the gold plated connection pins. The layer of gold on the connection pins is actually quite thick in comparison with other plating. You are also going to find contacts with partial gold plating, or just the tips of them gold plated. Manufacturers have gotten pretty good over the years of using less and less gold. Although in the end, all data connections, all connectors are gold plated. Now, on these high-grade boards, you're going to find large, square, and rectangular chips. If you were to take the top of that chip and remove it, you would find multiple gold bonding wires, 1 micron thick, attached to each one of the silver contacts on the sides of the chip. The next valuable item located on the board is the monolithic ceramic capacitors. These rectangular shaped components can vary in size and in color. They'll be marked on the board with a C and then a number, such as in this one, C45. They are extremely valuable due to the silver and palladium content. They can easily be removed from the board with heat and a spatula. Here is the bottom side of the hard drive motor. You will find gold leaf contacts. There's not a lot of gold here. Now, this is an older hard drive. On newer hard drives, you're not going to find screws to remove the whole motor. The only way to remove the motor is with a punch, and it's really not worth the time. This one actually had 3 screws holding it in, but you're not going to find a lot of hard drives like this anymore. If you get a bunch of them, you can sell them on eBay. If not, they go straight into the aluminum bin. Here is the forged aluminum housing. This particular housing weighed 0.5 pounds. Like, comment, subscribe. I want to hear what you think. And again, thanks for watching.